Hello everybody, and welcome to part 38 of my Final Fantasy VII Let's Play. And, we're continuing on, we're still here in, Cosmo Canyon here. We haven't gone to talk to, Bugenhagen yet, so we're going to, talk to him. And, I'm guessing you guys have already noticed that, I kind of swapped, my uploads here. I was busy and I couldn't do my post comms here for this video. So I decided, well, I'll just go ahead and get my Lego Lord of the Rings final video up, and I'll just use that. I'll just upload that instead and get that done and over with. So that series there is done. I mentioned in the video I had no idea what I'm going to be doing doing next there, so I'm going to be doing some looking around here. There's a Steam sale going on right now, so I might see what's going on there. You know, there's the Christmas winter sale going on right now, and I might find something. Never know. I might find something that I'll do for my channel here, but for right now, going for what's going on screen. Bugenhagen here is gonna have everybody come into his little like observatory little thing there, and kind of figure out what to do, and well, I don't know. They're like trying to think of like what they're I guess fighting for or something. I don't know. It's kind of not established like what they're doing here per se, because it's just, hey, let's just go here because they heard the planet cry. It's like, oh yeah. So everybody says that they think about Aerith a lot, and that leads them to, like, what she did, and it just kind of leads to, like, what she did in her final, like, minutes of, you know, doing whatever that she did, and, I guess it just brings them to go do something, back at the Forgotten City there. Which, we're actually going to be going there next. Since we got the Key of Ancients there, we don't have to, like, stop what we're doing. I mean, you can do it, like, after all this cutscene there. I would recommend after this, I would go and get, the Key of Ancients where you saw me get it. If you watched my previous episode there for this game, then, you'll see, where it's located. It's right underneath it's underneath the northern continent there. You had to be underwater though, because you can't go past a certain point, so yeah, you gotta submerge and go through some tunnels. You gotta submerge anyway, so you might as well just travel underneath the water there and find a little cave there and just run into the key there. And so one thing this is the last of my footage here. I think whatever link this video is, I'm just using up my footage there. After this video is done, I need to go record again, and I will be going to get some extra stuff there. I think I might actually go a little bit of choco breeding, not too much, just to get like some certain materials. I still need to go to the Calm Traveler and exchange the guidebook for the underwater materia, so I can maybe attempt to go after the Emerald Weapon, but I don't know if I want to go against him just yet. I think really what I'm going to do is, when we get to after we go into Midgar again and all that is said and done with, it actually kind of transitions to CD3. Like, you'll get a cutscene where the High Wind just basically transforms into, I guess, a better better engines or something, I don't know. So then you're on your way to the northern crater there, but before we can do that, I will probably most likely just go do all that extra stuff there. I gotta get some materials from the Chocobo Racing. I gotta go to the Materia Caves there to get, like, Knights of the Round and Mime and all that other stuff there. I also have to go, speaking of being here, if you have, this thing right here won't happen if you don't have either Bahamut or Neo Bahamut. If you miss either of those, this will not happen. And, also, it won't happen if you don't get the materia there. I think, like, one of them you just get automatically. In connection with this here, we also, when we're near the end of the game there, I might actually go after the Master Materia stuff there. But I would have to, I can probably, well, actually, this is another thing, is I have to travel into the Northern Crater first to get some of the remaining, like, green materia. So then I can master, because the ones that are in the last area is the shield materia, and I think there might be one other one. I don't think there might be another one, but that would be the last one that I need to get. Then after that, I need to actually grind to master them. And then I should be able to get the Master Materia there. Now, I could go after Emerald Weapon and get the Earth Heart from him. And that would get me it would just get me a free set of the Master Materias there. The green, the yellow, and the red. There is no master support. If you see any things that says that there is a master support there, there's no master support material there. So it's just the three colors there: green, yellow, and red, and that's it. So right here, I'm gonna go on what's on screen here. I'm actually fast forwarding the little travel there. I'm actually just speeding up some spots where it's like I don't necessarily have to cut it out, because then I don't have to worry about, like, time cuts and all that. But, you know, like right here, I'm actually speeding it up again just to show you where you need to go. And, so anyways, yeah, I gotta do a lot of side stuff, we get to disc 3. And, I will probably kind of maybe do a montage of that stuff. I don't know. I'm not really sure. But, when we get to it, we'll get to it. So for right now, what's going on screen right now is, we're gonna activate, this, like, waterfall projector thing here, and it's gonna show us, really something we've already seen. Like, in my honest opinion, like, this is sort of pointless, because we've already know about it, like, we've already seen it, and, so, it's basically what's going to happen is we're going to insert the Key of Ancients. Bugenhagen is going to do it for us. It's going to activate a waterfall, which is going to act as a projector screen. And it's just going to show us, like, what happened, you know, what Aerith did while she was praying. You know, basically what she was doing at this place here, and it just shows that, oh yes, she did pray for Holy, and that her white materia is pale green, which is what which is what it's supposed to be, what's supposed to happen for Holy to be activated. And that's all it is. Just says, okay, Holy is there, but something is blocking it, and blah, blah, blah. It's, oh, surprise, surprise. Oh, it's Sephiroth for some odd reason. And, so, it's, yeah, like I said, it's kind of a week, like, you know, get things going kind of thing, because you can technically, if you just took this out and everyone was just like, oh, yeah, her white material there that she had, and it fell from her, and it was already pale green, because I remember that. But it's like, I don't know, it's like they have to see this to get them motivated to go do something else, but it's like, as soon as we leave here, you'll see. I'm not going to spoil it here. I'm kind of getting ahead of myself here a little bit. But, I don't know, it just seems kind of pointless to just see all this stuff, and it's like, I already know this. Like, if you're paying attention to any of this, you'd be like, oh yeah, that's right, that's what happened. And I guess that's what this is. It's just be like an oh yeah moment. And, like, whatever. But, I kind of feel, speaking of Christmas, ho ho ho, I kind of sort of hate Bugenhagen a little bit, because he seems like snarky, I guess the word is. Like, he just seems like he's a smart ass kind of thing. Like, like this right here, he's like, oh, there's some writing here, and Cod's like, can you read it? And he's like, no. It's like, well, then why'd you tell me there's that? What'd you make me think that you could read it? But, I guess he points out about this there, which I don't know why nobody had seen it. I mean, you don't even have to, like, watch the little cutscene that they show here. It's just this, you just see this, and it says black materia on it. And, I don't know, it's... Basically, this is telling us is that, it's the white materia that is our only hope to counter meteor, and only an ancient can use it, I guess. I'm only assuming that, because I mean, it's materia, so I don't know if anybody can use it. But the thing is that, like I said, it has to be used, and it has to turn pale green, which they'll... I guess Bugenhagen will tell us. I mean, I don't know why Bugenhagen couldn't just tell us all this. I mean, I guess he wanted us to see it, but I don't know. It's weird. I mean, you'll see what I'm talking about here. That's the key there that we got from underground, from underwater there, and this is what it does. So it does this like little waterfall thing that goes around it. I don't know how it forms like a circle around it to where it goes all the way around the thing, but sure, I guess. So you are able to move right there after Bugenhagen stops talking right there. You just want to go inside, and it will trigger this scene here. And I mean, this is just basically what it is here. We'll just be watching this thing, and then they'll be like, oh yeah. So we get this little CG cutscene here, and so you see, I was about to say Sephiroth. If you see Aerith here, you'll see that she's praying, and then it cuts to the scene where she... where the thing fell out, you know, as she died. And like, as you can see there, it's the pale green, and I guess it just shows like it just shows like it's all pale green and shining like that. And then that's it. That's all they see, and it's just like, oh, I guess it's glowing. Okay. And that's the other thing I hate about Bugenhagen. He says that ho 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 thing, and it's like, what is that? I mean, I know it's supposed to be like maybe some kind of laugh or something, but it's weird. But Aerith, in her mind, thought that she was the only one. I mean, it was kind of makes sense, because I guess it was like, because Aerith was an ancient, she's the only one that can use the white materia there. So she went upon herself to leave Cloud and the party to go to that forgotten city where we're at right now and go and pray. I don't know. She might have been there for a good while, so it might have taken a long time for her to gather up, like the MP or whatever to get, you know, summon this thing. And, so she's, I'm sure she probably prayed there for a good long while, and then when we got there, I guess, the Genova Sephiroth killed, Aerith there, and so now, I think it was, I'm just gonna say this as a theory, I don't know if it's confirmed or not, but I think what happened was that the Genova Sephiroth sensed that Aerith was praying and trying to summon Holy, and she succeeded in praying for it, but she got killed. Like regardless, like they just killed her off. You know, he was like, "Well, I'll kill her off anyways." So just so like any other chance of her intervening would be cut loose and wouldn't have to worry about it. Now, I guess what they didn't anticipate was that since she already prayed for it, it's already active right now, and it's just waiting for the right moment to strike. It's really when the plant is in dire need, and that's when Holy is supposed to activate. And that's where this whole thing comes into play, to where at the end of the game, you know, it's like, oh, is it gonna activate or what? And well, we'll see. So we got a call from Kate Sith here, and it says that they moved the Junin cannon, because we noticed it was gone earlier when we were going to the underwater reactor. And I guess all that time that we were doing that underwater reactor stuff there, they had moved it to Midgar, and they made all the preparations to get it all set up and, you know, pointed directly at the northern crater there, because they're actually going to use the Maker reactors around Midgar to power the cannon, because I believe what it was is that the huge materia that was stationed there was used to power the cannon. So since it got removed, or they were moving it, they couldn't fire it from there. So they moved it here, and as you can see right here in this cutscene, there it's all set up, and they got it all rigged to use Mako reactor energy. And this thing is visible from the world map there. You'll see it all set up like this. Because I mean, this cannon is really huge. I would think it takes up a lot of power just to fire something from this thing. So we get this little cutscene with President Rufus and, you know, the gang here. And I guess Scarlet is the one that's kind of like being in charge of all this. I guess maybe Hedegger there too. They pretty much got the things moving, and so they're kind of like taking over the operation of this there. I guess the president is like, yeah, okay, you can go ahead. And I guess he's being, I guess the president is being okay with it because they're using it to go after Sephiroth. So it's technically they're having the same objectives as we are, but they're kind of going about it differently than we are. So, I mean, we'll see here. So I'm going to be doing a little cut here after this little cutscene here. I'm going to be skipping past all the travel to go back outside because that's where we're going to go. That's just like right here. I'm just back outside here. And as soon as you try to get onto the high wind there, you'll get this cutscene there. You'll get the same little thing there if you use like a gold chocobo or something like that, because you are able to do the chocobo breeding at this point. As soon as Meteor has been summoned, you should be able to do your chocobo breeding there. So this thing here, this guy is walking so slow. Like, just look how slow he's walking. And it took like I think 10 minutes for him just to get from where that was there to. He's going towards Midgar right now. So he's it took like I said, it took a long time for him to get there. So I was just kind of standing there, like I don't know what I should be doing. Well, not I knew what I was doing, but it's just like I thought, well, maybe I could go do something else there, but I didn't do anything. I think I saw a video at one point to where they actually went to Gold Saucer and they like raced their chocobos, and then they came back and. As soon as they got back to him, he was like super close, I guess, but they made it in time. And it's like, wow, it took a long time. I don't know. I mean, you are able to travel around, but I don't know, like, if you're able to go anywhere. I don't know if, like, you try to go somewhere, it says, you know, actually, they're like, oh no, we need to go defend Midgar or something. I don't know. So, anyways, that kind of gives. Kind of gives them kind of they shouldn't really care about Midgar per se. I mean, but Barrett made a point that the Marlene is there and so is Aerith's mom, and so they need to go and intervene with the weapon there is called Diamond Weapon. He's kind of hard, I guess. If you're not well prepared, he could probably kick your ass if you don't have enough levels there and go about things the right way. With the diamond weapon there, when you do fight him, you are able to steal a weapon from him. It's called Rising Sun. That's for Yuffie, and I believe that's a double. Growth weapon. It's not really interested in me because I already have a weapon that has the double there, and even then we'll have other characters there that have a better double growth and triple growth. There's two characters that only get the triple growth stuff there. And that is Cloud and Cid there. And we actually already have one of the triple growth ones, which is the Scimitar, which is for Cid there. I haven't equipped it yet, but once I do my grinding there, I'll be going to do that there. I'll probably have my levels all maxed out there because I'm pretty close to that already. And so yeah. So, you know, Cloud's here is just kind of taking the initiative here, and let's just go beat Weapon. And, yeah, they're just like, can we win against that thing? Because that Weapon is huge. I guess in battle, he is kind of tall. But, I mean, it's not too bad. So I'm going to be doing, as soon as I land, I'm going to be doing some little jump edits here. I'm just going to speed things up here. So Fortunately, the music kind of cut off there, and it's gonna be silent here for a little bit. So, yeah. So I'll BRB when the joke edits there are all done there. So, BRB.
1 hour later. 2 hours later. 3 hours later.
Yeah, like I said, it really took a long time for him to get here. Like, no joke. Like, it was... I kind of wish they kind of sped that up, because, I mean, you're not that far from Midgard there. I mean, it's just a short little ride there. I wish they would have sped that up a little bit. But, yeah, it took about, I don't know, like 5-10 minutes for him to get there, and it's like, oof. So Diamond Weapon here, he doesn't really have any weaknesses against anything particular. So just kind of do some heavy hitting summons and magic, and be sure to do Big Guard and regen, and you know, just kind of keep that up, and just make sure that everybody stays healthy. And he doesn't have a lot of HP. I think he has like, I think it's like 50,000 or something like that. He has like quite a bit, but it's not like terribly much. So you should be able to like take care of him in a short amount of time. If you do the chocobo race, the chocobo breeding stuff there, and you get like a go chocobo, and you go get like Knights of the Round there, you'll be fine. Just use Knights of the Round, and that will take care of him easily. This, you know, that's basically cheesing it. That summon there is ridiculously OP, because it hits like I think 12 times or something like that. I don't remember how many times it hits, but if your magic is really high and if it can do like 9,999 damage, then it's basically the best summon in the game. Which I mean, it is regardless. I mean, so he does not have any enemy skills either. Would be kind of weird to have a boss that has an enemy skill, really. Other than that, like I said, just be sure to keep your barriers up and your regen going. He does do, I think, a countdown. He's already doing it right now. I believe he does I think it does it here. He does an attack, and it actually really does hurt. I think it does like a couple thousand damage there. I think it brought me down to like 3,000 damage, I would think. I don't remember. But I'm kind of going through some summons there just to be sure that I got like I showed them off, because I don't recall any of them doing, you know. I think this is probably the first time I showed off Odin. I don't think I might be the first time. I probably not. But yeah, this is Odin right here. Actually, yeah, I think I did show him off. The other, yeah, this is the attack right here, is the diamond flash. And he does this little thing there, and it really hurts. Yeah. Actually, it took out a lot. Like, I think 8,000. I was almost at full health right there, and it took me down to 1,000 whatever there. So, it was yikes. It was enough to get Cloud to his limit break, and I used the Omni Slash here, and I do believe this finishes him off, which is, I guess, an interesting end. And there we go. So that was actually kind of neat that the timing of the the my custom music there was actually, and that's the Black Mage version of the boss fight music there. At the Black Mage group there is the original composer's band or whatever, like their music group there, and they've redone some of some scores there from past Final Fantasy games, and they're really good. You should check them out. I don't think they've done that many right now, because I think they only done like 1, 3, 6 and 7 and 8, I think, and I think 10 as well. And they only got like maybe like 10 songs, and that's it. So, this is kind of a thing here. Since both of these guys attacked at the same time, so to speak. Shinra is gonna fire first, and it's gonna take a little bit to get to them. And while that is traveling to Weapon is going to an attack as well. And it's kind of gonna do well. I mean, you'll see it here. I'm getting ahead of myself here. Let's watch this little cutscene here. So this is what I was talking about. They're using the reactors there, whatever's left there, and it's actually 7 there, because we destroyed it should be 6 of them, because we destroyed 2 of them already. Unless they rebuilt them, I don't know. But yeah. I mean, I guess it's whatever. This is how this thing fires, and it's actually firing a particular energy. It's like highly focused, like Mako energy being shot, and like you can see here, they kind of like attack at the same time. I don't know why Diamond Weapon is firing right now. I thought he would have gotten a lot closer. And so they'll kind of do a thing to where they both get attacked, and kind of share luck that they go past each other. Like they're like hit each other, which is kind of weird. So that right there, that I guess killed Diamond, because we don't fight Diamond ever again. I guess this is like this here is that's the end of it. I guess this is another instance of Shinra like doing the final blow to one of the weapons there, because the Sapphire one, they blew off its head, and this one they shot right through it. So I mean, Shinra don't mess Shinra doesn't take any shit from anybody, you know. You know, I give them credit for getting stuff done here. So this is the result of the Shinra's shot. It actually did hit the crater there, and the barrier that was there is now gone. And that's that gives us reason to go there after we have to go into Midgar again, which this video here will be saving right before we gotta go do that. Once you hover over Midgar there, it will activate the little scene there. And there's actually a speedrun tactic to get past all that. I'm not gonna like skip any of this, because I actually do want to get everything for that section there too. Because if you do a little trick to where you skip that, you actually miss out on some really good items. Like you'll miss out on Barret's final weapon, You'll miss out on the W item, and you'll miss out on, I'm trying to think of the other thing, but I don't remember. You miss out on like three things, I think, and it's nothing you want to get, nothing you want to skip. So, on my way over there, we gotta go over to the, we're going over to the crater here to see if, let's see what's going on there. So they ask if Sid can actually land in there, and Sid actually can land in there, because I guess they have a way of getting in there. It's no surprise. They'll be just throwing down a rope there that we'll climb down and we'll be getting into. But we're not going to be doing that yet because, Kaseth here is acting a little weird here, and we kind of see what's going on here. And so these three here are having, I guess, a little meeting. I don't know what this is. And as you saw in that the little cutscene before, it seemed like the president was actually killed. They're actually acting like the president is killed, but if you see Evan Children, you'll see that he's actually still alive. So so the president is not dead. I guess he kind of just escaped somewhere from the wreckage. I don't know. I guess they meet up later or something. But, so, I guess Scarlet and, Heidegger, here, they, I guess, assume that he's dead, and they're kind of just taking over. And, they're just kind of, they actually, do their own experiment, to where they create, like, a little mech monster. And we'll be dealing with that later. Just to kind of hint about that. So, they're trying. What's going on here is that the Mako reactor valve stuff is not shutting off. The reason is because someone else is trying to do it themselves there, and we'll see right here. It's Hojo, and he's at the little thing there, and he's trying to. I don't know what he's doing. I mean, he can't really do anything with the Mako here. I guess he's just trying to like shoot more energy towards the crater. I guess I don't know. We actually don't really see what Hojo actually completes here. He doesn't actually complete anything. He basically stays there and working however long he's still there. When we go to him here, he's still working on the computer there. So it's like, I guess he didn't get to finish what he was doing. And, We'll be seeing probably most of this in the next video there. I'm not really sure how it's going to be edited up to get all this done here, because going back into Midgar there, it's not going to take exactly too long there. I mean, it'll probably take about 30 minutes to get through it. Maybe more because of the other extra stuff that's there, but other than that, shouldn't take too long there. So it might be one or two videos there for the whole going back to Midgar section there. And so this right here, this is K6's cover being blown, and it's revealed that Reeve was the one that was controlling Kaseth. I don't know how that works, but it's yeah, it's kids that doing that. I guess at some point Ryu kind of goes into hiding and continues to just to control Kate Sith from there. I don't know. I don't know how the, how Kate Sith really works. He's just there. I mean, it would have been better if it was just like a guy in a suit or something like that, and like the cat on the head was actually like a like the Kate Sith doing all the talking there. But I don't know. It's it would have been better if it was just they just made Kate Sith an actual person instead of like it being Reeves or something like that. I don't know. It's yeah. So, so basically, I guess right here, Kate Sith is explaining that Hojo is making it so those valves don't close or whatever, keeping them going, and it's gonna overload the reactors there, and it's gonna blow up actually Midgar, like the entire city there, and everyone in it is gonna die, which is kind of weird because it will actually kill Hojo too, but I guess he's willing to die for that. But so again, we got it. You know, it's really the only reason is that they go back into Midgar is because they want to save Midgar from blowing up so it doesn't kill Marlene and Aerith's mother. If those two people were not there, I don't think they would give a shit. I really do. I don't think. I mean, they would probably have a little conscience on you know, all those people there. But I mean, really, if they think about it, if they just let that place just go up and let everyone, you know, everybody else come together and reform, like, I guess the government or whatever, you know, and let Shinra just fall, you know, crumble down, which I guess it kind of did, so to speak. But, I mean, at this point, I mean, it's just like, that's the only reason why they're worried about that. And, I don't know, it's just kind of weird. But, so... Once this cutscene is done there, I am going to be traveling to a new spot in the mountains there that, I haven't gone to yet. I could have gone to it earlier, but on my way back, I kind of noticed it. I'm like, oh, wait, let me stop there and hit all of that, but, I don't know. Yeah, they just, I guess they detain, Reeve here, and he just, I guess controls Kate Sith, from wherever he's at, I don't know. So, but anywho. This is one thing I don't, like, understand is how does Kate Sith move around and all that? Is it, like, controlled by the cat? Like, is the cat on the top of the thing there, like, controlling it? I don't know. I really don't understand it too well. So, like I said there, once we head to Midgar there. Well, I'm not gonna be going into Midgar because I was like recording for like 3 hours for this thing there, and I was like, all right, this is a good time to stop. But I saw that right there. This little place right here. If you land in the green there and go to this house, this is, the Chocobo Sage, Sage's place. And if you talk to the green Chocobo here, you'll get this fourth, enemy skill there, which I don't know why you need a fourth one. Three is enough. So I guess it's just in case if you miss one, but, this character here, he kind of has like these, like, forgetful moments, and over a course of time, if you get all this information from him, you can go back to the Chocobo ranch there and tell the sister there, I guess what it is, the little girl that in a red dress there, she heard a rumor about or a myth about this guy, because he was like a legendary like chocobo breeder or something, and I guess he got secluded over here. I'm going to be spinning this stuff here. He has some two greens that you can only buy here. And it's whatever. But I don't know. We're going to be ending the video off here, sir. So, eh. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please go to my channel and check out my other videos there if you would like. And also, please like, comment, and subscribe. And I will catch you guys in the next video there. So peace out.